So, a little background on me. My name is Mark Reichow. I'm a concept development technical director for Walt Disney Imagineering, born out of Glendale, California, in the creative services field. I've been with Imagineering for a little over 20 years. First 17 of those years, I was in the illusion special effects group, just specifically designing the magic and stuff for our parks around the world. My role on this project was actually design a kind of magic that would kind of complement the story that we have going on in this film here. And that's kind of what I did. And the story is really important to us, obviously. The story for this place kind of goes back, if I run through it real quick for you. This building was built in about 1925 because there was a growing need to have an indoor farmer's market for the Springs community. And this is a place that farmers would come, bring their vegetables and produce and such and sell to the community. And that went really well for about 25 years until kind of the American shopping market changed a little bit. And farmers started to leave, people started to leave, and the building became empty. And it was one day that a group of young animators came to it and thought, this would be a great place to put an East Coast Disney animation studio. And so they did. And they came in, and for about the next 35 years, they animated and created things in here, some of our most favorite things that we've seen and love. And that went on until, I guess, when they left about 1989, they left a bunch of magical stuff behind. And the building was empty again for a little while, about the mid-90s. There was a desire to do more shopping here, right? So, World of Disney Store opened. And at the beginning of 2018, the store thought, you know, we should pay homage to those animators and the great work that they did. And what you're seeing today is a result of that. It's all inspired by that. Some of the stuff that they left behind, one of the things they left behind, I should say, were ink and paint jars. And so as we started propping these shelves with them and stuff, we discovered that there's a little bit of magic left inside of those jars. And as you see here, we also put up some enchanted art on the sides over here. This was some of the stuff that was left behind. And so you can, if you notice, the paint with the magic gets out and starts blurring. It escapes, and it's looking for something to enchant, so it enchants the first thing that comes to.
Do you guys have any questions?
Do you have any questions?
Can you guys get a little closer?
Yeah. And you can move around and get some shot and get out of the way here if you like to get a better shot.
Any questions
from Alan? So, when you're talking about enchanting, like things are like lighting up and, you know, things are moving. Can you talk us through some of your favorite ones that are around the store?
Around the store? Yeah, there's a few things. As the story goes, that the animators left behind. Ink and paint jars. This is one of my favorites. I'm very, very close to this one. They also left some sketches laying around that got framed and put up to try to celebrate. They become enchanted as well. Another area, if you walk through the store over here in the front of the store, you'll find some old movie posters that were also left behind. Different generations. And they also got magic left and then they become enchanted and change from poster to poster. So it's, if you haven't seen them, you gotta make sure to get over to the store.
Okay, so I noticed Tinkerbell going around. Are there elements like Tinkerbell throughout the whole store?
Yeah, I mean, you actually don't see Tinkerbell here. You see Pixie Dust magic, which magic can manifest itself in a lot of different ways. This flavor of magic here, actually, it's all Disney magic. Disney magic tends to manifest itself in Pixie Dust in one form or another. Every place that gets enchanted, you'll find a little bit of that. Right there.
Are there similarities or differences between this store and the one in California?
Yeah, absolutely. Actually, we actually designed them together. So it was reimagined in both locations. Each building's a little bit different, but the elements that you find in them are the same. So if you went out there, you'd visit, it looked a lot like this. It feel a lot like this.
And is the story similar there?
And the story is a little bit different the way that it was crafted back there because it is a little bit different location than it is here. But in general, it manifests itself in the same kind of experience that you're feeling here, same kind of magic. So that feels like Disney. That's the main thing. We wanted it to feel like the kind of feelings that you get when you go to the park. I want to bring that into the store. As Disney Spring is being reimagined on an ongoing basis, this was just, it was nice to kind of get some of this. Maybe the first magic like this that you see.
Thanks.
I noticed some of the drawers are very reminiscent of what we could actually find like at the Imagineering archives in terms of storing artwork.
Yeah, absolutely.
Little touches like that. Are there anything else in terms of details or stories or a little bit of sort of extra magical touches or references that we can look for throughout the store?
Yeah, if you look at some of the checkout counters and stuff here, you'll find some different artwork from different animators, each one of them kind of has their own kind of space. If you go, there's artwork on these, there's a story behind each of these. This is a Mark Davis version over here that has some of this stuff. Something unique about him is he actually worked in animation, but he also worked in theme parks. He's one of the, you get that, like a pirate and things like that. So, yeah, to answer your question, yeah, it should be riddled all over the store here, which makes it kind of fun to go looking for.
You can shoot.
Yeah, let me get out of the way and let you guys get some better shots.